Hello, my name is Dallas and I am a representative of TransEd. This video provides a technical explanation of the root cause investigation into what caused the cracks on some of the piers supporting elevated tracks on the Valley Line Southeast LRT. In this video, I will explain how the forces on the piers led to the cracking, which in turn led to the discovery of inadequate internal steel reinforcement in the piers. To begin, let me explain why steel reinforcement is used in concrete construction. Rebar is a steel bar used to strengthen concrete. Concrete is a strong material, but it does not flex or bend. When rebar is added to concrete, it helps to absorb forces that are applied to it. Where the elevated guideway curves, the piers are subject to two main forces from the tracks above: thermal expansion forces and forces from the train as it goes along the curved tracks. These unique forces are illustrated here by the arrows of different color and size. Let's look closely at where the pier arms meet the pier leg. As the forces from the tracks above are applied to the pier arm, it wants to move sideways. This causes tension in the concrete, and without enough rebar, the forces can create cracks. Our engineers have concluded that the pier cracking is the result of inadequate internal steel reinforcement in the piers. So what are we going to do to correct this? First, we have 9 piers that need minor strengthening. This drawing illustrates how we will remove a small amount of concrete, drill, and place new rebar embedded into the concrete to add additional structural support. On other piers, we will be installing external structural steel where the arms meet the leg of the pier. Think of these supports like a belt around the waist of the pier that provides additional support. This drawing illustrates the steel belt. The final look of the piers is still being discussed with our city partners. Let's switch our focus to the concrete that will be added in the gap of the Y, or the V infills. We will also add these new concrete V infills to stiffen and strengthen the pier arms. Adding this concrete reduces how much the pier arms can bend and moves the point where it would bend upwards. Here, the pier arms can rely upon the already installed rebar to better resist the forces I mentioned at the start. Finally, we will also seal minor surface cracks in the piers. These surface cracks form as part of regular concrete curing and are to be expected. These cracks are small, and we will seal them to prevent water from getting inside the concrete and causing corrosion to the rebar. As you can see, some of this work has already begun. We know it looks a little messy right now, but work is progressing well. Thank you for taking the time to listen to this update. We look forward to sharing more updates with you as the pier repairs progress.